In Disney Infinity 3.0, there's great potential to create fun racing games. Creating a race in the toy box between two players is actually quite easy, but the possibilities of competing against AI opponents can seem quite limited at first. However, there are a few easy ways to get around it. My name is Coming Clean, and this will be a quick tutorial on how to create racing games against the AI. We will now create a short race around this Monsters University campus area. Start by placing out the racetrack and select the theme you prefer. Technically, you don't actually need the track to create the race, but it fits most themes nicely. If your track is seamless, you can add a racetrack start piece and race against AI opponents, but the opposition is limited to the cast from the Cars franchise. Although it works fine, it might not be ideal for all toy boxes. To create a race against the AI opponents of your choice, you will need the following toys. A challenge maker, a logic gate, a counter, a text displayer, and the ground vehicle you want to race against. The vehicle will be riderless, so pick one where it isn't too obvious the driver is missing. Create a path around your track. Each path point you place will have a racing gate on them by default, but they can be turned off in the properties. Set up the path to be looped if you want to race with multiple laps. In this tutorial, I'm setting it to 2. Set up the challenge maker to start path point tracking when the invites are accepted, and make it end the path point tracking when the challenge ends. Make a logic connection from the path creator so that when the path race is complete, this will send an input signal to the logic gate. The output of the logic gate will tell the challenge maker that the challenge is completed. The logic gate might seem unnecessary right now, but we will get back to the importance of it in a moment. Connect the challenge maker to the text displayer and make it say "you win" if the challenge is completed, and make it say "you lost" if the challenge fails. Change the text style to banner. Connect the challenge maker to a locator that will act as the player 1's starting point. Add another one for player 2 if you want to bring a friend to your race. Lastly, you can, if you want to, make a default vehicle that your character automatically appears in when the challenge starts. Make another path that you intend for your opponent to drive. To make the opponent take a slightly different route each lap, I'm manually drawing the path 2 laps around the track. I am also setting the path to be looped. Adjust the properties of the path so that the speed is 300 and the auto start objects when connected is turned off. Connect your vehicle to the path and make sure you turn the orient along path and enable driving physics on. Make the challenge maker reset and play the path of the vehicle when the invites are accepted. You'll want the player to fail the challenge if the opponent reaches the goal first. To accomplish this, we are going to create a trigger area right after the finish line and connect it to the counter. Set up the trigger area so that when a vehicle enters, the counter increments by 1, and make the challenge maker reset the counter when the game is ended. At the start of the second and final lap, vehicles will have entered the trigger area 4 times. Now, 2 things can happen. The first is that the player reaches the goal first and wins the race. Since the goal comes right before the trigger area, the counter will not be incremented in this scenario. The second thing that can happen is that the opponent vehicle reaches the trigger area before the player reaches the goal. And if this happens, this will be the 5th vehicle to enter the trigger area. That means that we have to set the target count of the counter to 5 and make a logic connection from the counter so that when the target is reached, the logic gate closes. Now it is impossible for the player to win the race if the opponent comes first to the finish line. The input from the finish line of the track will, however, still be sent to the logic gate, but the input is now blocked. All we have to do now is to make a logic connection from the logic gate so that when the input is blocked, the challenge fails, and to reset the whole thing, the challenge maker needs to send a signal to the logic gate to open when the challenge starts. Now you can race your opponent. You will win if you reach the goal first, and if the opponent beats you, you can still finish the race, but you will fail the challenge. Adjust the path speed of the vehicle to adjust the difficulty.
Glad I could help out.
If you want your opponent's speed to vary during the race, you can adjust the speed percentage of the path points.
So close.
You can add more opponents to the same path. You can adjust the offsets so they have different starting positions, but once the race gets going, they will, however, line up to follow the exact same route. You might want to consider adding more paths if you want multiple opponents. Also, remember to adjust the counter to account for the new opponents. Of course, it's possible to use this same technique for aerial races. If you don't want to race riderless ghost vehicles, you have one other option. The decoration section of the toys actually has some authentic looking cars. However, they are in the game not considered to be vehicles, which means driving physics can't be turned on and they follow the path in a not so realistic way. Also, it won't be long before another problem presents itself. Though not perfect, the ground vehicles are the way to go. The destructible cars, however, works perfectly for a destruction derby race. More on that in a future video. One last thing I will go over is the car chase with the dynamic trigger. Create a challenge maker, a dynamic trigger, and the vehicle you want to chase. Connect the dynamic trigger to the vehicle and set the trigger distance to about 45. Now, make a logic connection from the dynamic trigger to the challenge maker and make the challenge fail if the player exits the trigger distance. As you can see, you can now not get too far from the vehicle or you will fail the challenge.
Rematch. I demand a
make
rematch.
A path that you want the vehicle to follow and connect the challenge maker to reset and play the path when the game starts. Here, I'm making the challenge start when the player mounts the motorbike. Now you can chase the vehicle through your toy box, and if you get too far away, the challenge will fail. This is Nick Fury chasing a stolen shield truck through a city, but using your imagination, you can find a lot more applications. Perhaps a bounty hunter struggling not to let his target get away, or maybe the Lone Ranger chasing a carriage sliding down a ridge. I hope you have fun creating your own race challenges. I'm always eager to learn new stuff to do in the TOYBOX, so if you like what you saw in this video, I would love to hear what sort of applications you can think of with the techniques I just showed. Finally, a quick shout out to the YouTuber Professor TOYBOX, who has some great, more slow-paced tutorials on how to set up races. Links are in the description. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned to this channel for more quick tutorials just like this one. My name is Coming Clean, and I'll see you next time. Take care.